The news is mostly positive. After a 1970s-era study found that kids draw scientists as males an astonishing 99.4% of the time, the trend has seen a dramatic reversal. In new research that looked at almost 80 studies over the ensuing decades, the number of kids who drew female scientists steadily increased. That change took place mostly among girls, so that by 1985, the number of girls who drew female scientists had risen from 1% to 33%. By 2015, it had jumped to 58%. Those numbers tell us we've reached a safer, wider place for girls who dream. That's a big deal. Still, that's where the good news for girls ends, or at least gets a lot murkier. While the youngest girls think expansively, middle and high school girls experience a mysterious contraction of their expectations. The study revealed that while 70% of 6-year-old girls draw a female scientist, only 25% of 16-year-old girls do. It's baffling and upsetting. There's more work to do, obviously, and the research provides some direction. Several recent studies show that simple gestures of inclusion, such as classroom posters and books featuring diverse female STEM figures, and inviting diverse female scientists into your classrooms as role models, can create a lasting impression of scientific competency in girls. And words matter too, perhaps more than we'd like to admit. Research shows that language that paints science as a male domain, by referring to boys as future scientists and girls as future women scientists, for example, can steer young girls away from the discipline. Finally, our approach to teaching math and science might be less appealing to girls. Ask a girl if she wants to be an engineer, and she's ambivalent, according to a recent study. But ask her if she wants to design irrigation systems to bring water to villages in need, and she's all in.